In this provider training video, we will demonstrate the coding for the Confusion Assessment Method, or CAM, based on the Brief Interview for Mental Status, or BIMS interview. The CAM is a standardized assessment that is used to determine if the patient or resident has signs and symptoms of delirium. The Confusion Assessment Method is completed by coding patient or resident behaviors that were observed during the Brief Interview for Mental Status, or BIMS interview. The BIMS interview, together with the CAM assessment, help providers determine needed support and identify possible delirium behaviors. For more information on the BIMS, please review the BIMS video tutorial located on the CMS YouTube channel. The intent of the CAM is to identify any signs or symptoms of acute mental status changes as compared to the patient or resident's baseline status. The CAM is composed of four sections. C1310A, Acute Onset Mental Status Change. C1310B, Inattention. C1310C, Disorganized Thinking. And C1310D, Altered Level of Consciousness. The CAM starts with C1310A, Acute Onset Mental Status Change. This item asks the clinician to assess if the patient or resident has had any alterations in mental status observed, reported, or identified that represents an acute change from baseline. Let's continue defining the items and the specific coding within the CAM assessment. C1310B, Inattention, asks the clinician to assess if the patient or resident has had any difficulty focusing attention, for example, being easily distractible or having difficulty keeping track of what was being said. Now that we understand the item, let's consider the coding for C1310B, Inattention. Code 0, Behavior Not Present. If the patient or resident remains focused during the assessment, and all other sources agree that the patient or resident was attentive during other activities. Code 1. Behavior continuously present, did not fluctuate. If the patient or resident had difficulty focusing attention, was easily distracted, or had difficulty keeping track of what was said, and the inattention did not vary. All sources must agree that inattention was consistently present to select this code. Code 2. Behavior present, fluctuates. If inattention is noted during the assessment, or any source reports that the patient or resident had difficulty focusing attention, was easily distracted, or had difficulty keeping track of what was said, and the inattention varied, or if information sources disagree in assessing level of attention. The CAM continues with C1310C, Disorganized Thinking. This item asks the clinician to assess if the patient or resident's thinking has been disorganized or incoherent. This is further defined as rambling or irrelevant conversation, unclear or illogical flow of ideas, or unpredictable switching from subject to subject. Now that we understand the item, let's consider the coding for C1310C, Disorganized Thinking. Code 0, Behavior Not Present. If all sources agree that the patient's thinking was organized and coherent, even if answers were inaccurate or wrong. Code 1, Behavior Continuously Present, did not fluctuate. If, during the assessment and according to other sources, the patient's responses were consistently disorganized or incoherent, conversation was rambling or irrelevant, ideas were unclear or flowed illogically, or the patient unpredictably switched from subject to subject. Code 2. Behavior present, fluctuates. If, during the assessment, or according to other data sources, the patient's responses fluctuated between disorganized, incoherent, and organized, clear. Also, code is fluctuating if information sources disagree. The confusion assessment method concludes with C1310D, Altered Level of Consciousness. This item asks the clinician to assess if the patient or resident has had any alterations in his or her level of consciousness. These states are identified as vigilant, lethargic, stuporous, or comatose. Vigilant is defined as the patient or resident startles easily to any sound or touch. Lethargic is defined as the patient or resident repeatedly dozes off when you are asking questions, but responds to voice or touch. Stupor is defined as the patient or resident being very difficult to arouse and keep aroused for the interview. Comatose is defined as the patient or resident not being able to be aroused despite shaking and shouting. Now that we understand the item, let's consider the coding for C1310D, Altered Level of Consciousness. Code 0. Behavior not present. If all sources agree that the patient was alert and maintained wakefulness during conversation, interviews, and activities. Code 1. Behavior continuously present, did not fluctuate. If, during the assessment and according to other sources, the patient was consistently lethargic, stuporous, vigilant, or comatose. Code 2. Behavior present, fluctuates. If, during the assessment or according to other sources, the patient's level of consciousness varied. For example, the patient was at times alert and responsive, while at other times the patient was lethargic, stuporous, or vigilant. Code as fluctuating if information sources disagree. Let's watch a nurse interview Mr. Miller in order to accurately code the BIMS and CAM cognitive assessment. It's important to note that for this coding scenario, the date is Tuesday, March 10th, 2020.
Ruth, before you go in and talk to Henry, can I have a word?
Yes, Mrs. Miller. What's on your mind?
Well, Henry has had quite a setback, and I just don't think he's the same. You know, like in his mind, he's very distracted and sometimes he can't focus on what we're talking about.
Yes, I reviewed his medical records and saw some mention made of that. Can you tell me how long this has been happening?
He was fine when he went into the hospital, but in the last few days, I've started noticing these changes. Is he going to be okay? I am so afraid.
Let me start by doing an assessment and getting some more information. Once I have a better idea of how he's presenting and any recent changes, I may have a better sense of what's going on. I can see that you're concerned, and we will do our very best to take care of Henry.
Okay, then. Let me go with you. I may be able to help. Henry? Henry, the nurse is here. Her name is Ruth. She's going to ask you a few questions.
Hi, Henry. How are you? I have a few questions that I need to ask you.
Yes, of course. Please have a seat.
Oh, thank you. Can you hear me all right?
Yes. I can hear you just fine.
He can get absorbed in reading the newspaper.
Well, I would like to ask you some questions. We ask everyone these same questions. This will help us provide you with better care. Some of the questions may seem really easy, while others may be more difficult.
Well, all right. Go ahead.
I'm going to say three words for you to remember. Please repeat the words after I've said all three. The words are sock, blue, and bed. Now, tell me the three words.
You mean bed, sock, and blue?
Yes, that's right. The words are sock, something to wear, blue, a color, and bed, a piece of furniture. Henry? Henry.
Henry, please pay attention to Ruth. I've seen him get like this a few times since he was discharged from the hospital. I don't know why he can't pay attention. He's really not like this usually.
Oh, what was that?
Henry, can you please tell me what year it is right now?
Sure. It's 2016.
Okay. And what month are we on right now?
It's cold outside. So it's winter.
Oh, he's so confused. He wasn't like this 2 days ago. His medication's changed, and ever since then...
I understand. Let me finish the interview, and then we can talk more about your concerns.
Oh, okay. Yes, let's do that, please.
Henry, what day of the week is today?
Well, it says right here that it's Tuesday.
All right, let's go back to an earlier question. What were those three words that I asked you to repeat?
Bed.
Mr. Miller?
Did you read the story about the Yankees? It's here in the paper. It's an incredible story. The Yankees.
Mr. Miller? Henry?
Yes, of course.
One word was something to wear.
Oh, it was socks.
Yes. And one word is a color.
I don't remember. Red, green, yellow, orange, blue, blue birds, blue bonnets, blue jays. The Blue Jays play the Yankees. We saw the Blue Jays play the Yankees. Remember that, Gladys?
Yes, Henry, that was a fun time.
Okay, Mr. Miller, I think I'm all set. Gladys, would you like to talk more about your concerns around Henry's medication?
Gladys, I'm tired. I want to go back to bed.
Sure thing. Let me just get you settled, Henry, and then Ruth and I can chat about a few other things.
The responses to C1310, signs and symptoms of delirium, are based on behaviors demonstrated by the patient or resident during the BIMS interview. We demonstrated the BIMS interview in the practice coding vignette you just viewed. How would you code C1310, signs and symptoms of delirium, from the CAM? Let's start with C1310A, acute onset mental status change. What is the correct code for C1310A, acute onset mental status change, for Mr. Miller? 0, no. 1, yes. The correct code for C1310A, acute onset mental status change, would be 1, yes. Mr. Miller demonstrated behaviors that signal an acute change in mental status. Based on his wife's report, these behaviors are new and represent a change from baseline. What is the correct code for C1310B, inattention, for Mr. Miller? Coding: 0, behavior not present. 1, behavior continuously present, does not fluctuate. 2, behavior present, fluctuates. Comes and goes, changes in severity. The correct code for C1310B, inattention, would be 2, behavior present, fluctuates. Mr. Miller demonstrated difficulty focusing attention, irrelevant conversation, and difficulty keeping track of what was said. Based on his wife's report, these behaviors are new and represent a change from baseline. What is the correct code for C1310C, disorganized thinking, for Mr. Miller? Coding: 0, behavior not present. 1, behavior continuously present, does not fluctuate. 2, behavior present, fluctuates. Comes and goes, changes in severity. The correct code for C1310C, disorganized thinking, would be 2, behavior present, fluctuates. Mr. Miller demonstrated disorganized thinking, irrelevant conversation, and switching from subject to subject. Based on his wife's report, these behaviors are new and represent a change from baseline. What is the correct code for C1310D, altered level of consciousness? Coding: 0, behavior not present. 1, behavior continuously present, does not fluctuate. 2, behavior present, fluctuates. Comes and goes, changes in severity. The correct code for C1310D, altered level of consciousness, would be 0, behavior not present. Mr. Miller did not demonstrate any symptoms of vigilance, lethargy, stupor, or comatose behaviors during the assessment. This video demonstrated coding for C1310, signs and symptoms of delirium, from the CAM, using behaviors demonstrated by a patient or resident during the administration of the BIMS interview. A recent deterioration in cognitive function may indicate delirium, which may be reversible if detected and treated in a timely fashion. We hope you found this video helpful. For more information on coding section C, cognitive patterns, refer to your setting-specific guidance manual, which can be found on the CMS website.